So when did you figure out that Robert Rizzo, the city manager, was making what he was making?
We'll get to that. we think an interesting story, but so we're now waiting for the documents, and we're starting to talk to people during this time, and you know we're hearing different things from different people, and you know getting different tips, and we're hearing, both of us are hearing, you know, Rizzo is making 300 grand a year, 400 grand a year. Okay, that's, you know, not so much higher than anything else. Then on day 9, after we've filed a public records request and they have 10 days to respond to it, this city clerk calls me and she says, Mr. Rizzo says you can get the documents tomorrow, but we would like to meet you and sit down and talk about the documents. So I say, fine. And I say, where? And she says, we'd like to meet you in Little Bear Park.
No, Little Bear Park. Let me tell you about Little Bear Park.
You guys have done this before, right?
No, I just like telling this part. When you hear little, really, the park is little. It's a small little park. And the park is really for children who are under the age of 12 or, you know, I think for 8-year-olds, basically. So it's a really small park. And they decide to meet with us in a conference room that is usually where the Boy Scouts meet. And, you know, Jeff and I arrived there separately, but I, on my way there, I just thought, a park? Why would you want to meet at a park? It's kind of like a big business deal, you know, a big business meeting that we're about to have with, you know, Bob Rizzo, and we didn't have any clue who was going to be there until we walk in, and, you know, sure enough, we see, you know, Bob Rizzo and,
Bob Rizzo is the city manager, and the assistant city manager, and the assistant to the city manager, and the police chief, and two councilmen, and a councilman from Maywood, and two attorneys.
Wow.
Okay? And then in this pile next are our documents.
Right.
And so what they expected is that we would, you know, look through the documents and ask them questions. And, you know, I'm not going to do that. I got the damn documents. What do I need to ask them questions about them for while they're sitting there? And so but we sort of ignored the documents. And so we start talking to them, and then I ask Bob Rizzo, so how much money do you make? You know, knowing that I'm assuming the contract is next to us, and he's kind of literally sort of coughs out $700,000.
Oh.
And I wasn't sure I heard him correctly. And I say, pardon me? Because I thought maybe he said 7,000, and it's a month or a week. And he says 700,000. And Ruben, who's sitting on my left, goes, Jesus Christ.
I was a little worried. I thought I'd given away the story. I'm like, oh no, they know. They know what the story is now. But at the same time, I was looking at Jeff when he asked that question, wait, did you say 7,000? You know, wait, how much? And I thought, did you not hear 700,000? Because I very distinctively heard it, wrote it, and said, Jesus Christ, in this conference room. And to me, that was just, you know, from there on. But then we start asking the assistant city manager, you know, we ask her, how much do you make?
And she says, I don't know. And Rizzo says, she makes about 350.
And isn't that also more than most regular city managers make?
Yes. And then I asked the police chief, how much do you make? And he says, 457.
Oh, my gosh.
And I say, well, how much? You had been the police chief in Glendale, retired, a week later takes a job in Bell. I say, how much did you make in Glendale? And I think he said, 215. You know, and you're just kind of going, you're thinking to yourself, man, oh, man, what is going on here? And that was sort of how we knew.
And how long was it then after that meeting until you could go and put everything together for your first story? And what else did you have to do to get that story ready?
Well, I think that meeting happened on a Friday. And The meeting lasted 4 hours of us interviewing them.
We figure it was probably at least $2,000 in legal bills with those two attorneys.
Yeah, just hours of asking questions after questions. We thought this is our only chance to get as many questions in and get answers to these questions. And among them was, how do you justify making these salaries? And, you know, there were sort of the council members. Well, Bob Rizzo said, you know, I brought the city out of bankruptcy when I started here. I've made the place a little better. You know, the parks, he was bringing about the parks. Also said that it brought in positive cash flow to the city. And even the council members were sort of backing him up on that. Yes, you know, there's better lighting now in the city. And again, going back to the parks were a big deal for them.
Right. And Rizzo made that the great quote, which I don't remember exactly, but something like, you know, people may choke on that when they read it, but, you know, I deserve it, or whatever he said.
He said, you know, I could, you know, if people are going to choke on that figure, you know, that's fine, but, you know, I can make that much money in the private sector. And, you know, I think, what was it that you told me you were thinking about?
Well, I literally almost had to stick my hand in my mouth to not say, well, go ahead and get a job in the private sector.
Right. But after that, we had all weekend to go through these documents, and then, you know, we realized that the contract was the amazing part of this story, was that he had created these contracts where he could sort of boost the salary every year and have, like, these 12% increases, and they made a lot of modifications to his contract, which allowed him to get to that point where we reported.
Didn't he go from 400 up to over 700 in just a few years?
Well, he starts off in 1993, I think, was making, I believe it was 73.
76.
76. And then it keeps climbing. And when you look at the contract, it doesn't say, you know, $787,000 a year. You had to be able to do fourth grade math and percentages to figure these things out. It would say how much the raises are. And I'm doing the addition, and Ruben is double-checking me on it. And then eventually I call Rizzo, and I said, listen, you know, you said you make $700,000, and I come up with $787, how is my math wrong? And he says, well, I think you're $20,000-$30,000 high, but that's okay. And so I tell Ruben this, and I say, you know, we'll go with my figure. If after we write the story, he wants us to write a correction that says, Bob Rizzo doesn't make $787, he only makes $750, I will write that correction. But back to how long it took us, right? It was a Friday, that meeting happened.
Right, Friday, and then I think we worked Saturday, and we were discussing about
right.
it. But Monday, I think we finally got down to writing it.
Well, we had to look at the contracts and start figuring
right.
things out. On the contracts. And then,
yeah, there was a lot of math involved. I mean, and you had to read these contracts word for word. I mean, you could have skipped out 5% increase beginning in September of 08. You know, and like, oh, we need to add that with what we're adding. But essentially, by Monday, we sat down and we started writing, and we did the interviews already, and so we were set to go.
Right. So then it came out next Sunday?
No, I don't think that story came out on Sunday.
Came out on a weekday, I believe. It was Tuesday or Wednesday. It was mid-June. And I think it was on a Monday that we wrote it, because it came out Tuesday. So I remember I had to do coverage reaction with residents, which is another story there itself.
And that's something that I like to go into, because the reaction what this series has spawned has seemed to me incredible. Multiple government investigations, citizens group coming together, the entire Los Angeles City payroll put on a website in the effort of transparency spawned by your story. What is that like for you guys to see your stories resulting in this reaction across the city, across the state?
Well, for me, it's rewarding. I mean, it's rewarding to bring, I think as a journalist, that's one of your biggest things that you want to accomplish in your career, which is to bring positive changes, to be responsible for those changes. And I think, to me, that's just been the rewarding part. And also to know that I've allowed these residents in Bell to sort of have their voices be heard, which is something that hasn't happened for them in a very long time. And this has, I mean, there's a lot of anger that they have at this council, at the administration itself, just very